OMC Universal Power Limited by Share was founded in 1993. It is a large private enterprise engaged in motorcycle engine, general power machine production. Its products are sold in more than 100 countries and regions around the world. With the improvement of environmental protection concepts, it has also begun to dabble in outdoor power stations. ChargerLAB this time got a portable power station EP1650 from EHOM. It can support an output power of up to 1650 watts. The built-in LFP battery has a capacity of 1024 watt-hour. It also features spur flux technology, which can break through the rated power in a short time to drive more powerful electrical appliances. It is equipped with 3 European AC outlets, 2 USB-C ports, 3 USB-A ports, and a car port. The weight of it is about 13 kg. Its size is about 333 by 268 by 263 mm. Some specs info are pasted here. The battery capacity is 20 Ah, 50 and 1.5 watts, 1024 watt-hour. The car port can support an output of 12 volts, 8 amp, 96 watts. Each USB-C port can output up to 20 volts, 5 amp, and the total output power of 2 USB-C ports is 200 watts. Each USB-A port can output up to 12 volts, 1.5 amp, and the total output power of 3 USB-A ports is 54 watts. The box contains the power station, an AC power code, a car charger, and some documents. The power code is European type. It has a matte one-piece shell, and the color of it is gray and white. There is an LCD on the upper left corner of the front. The LCD can display the remaining power, input and output power, and available time. There are 5 USB ports and a car port. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C port can support FCP, SCP, AFC, QC3.0, QC5, SFCP, PD3.0, BPS, DCP, and Apple 2.4M protocols. And it has 5 fixed PDOs of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, and 20V, 5A, and a set of BPS. Move to the USB-A. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows that the USB-A port can support FCP, SCP, EFC, QC3.0, SFCP, DCP, and Apple 2.4N charging protocols. Next, let's see the charging compatibility of the USB-C. We have compiled the test result into a bar chart. The highest charging power is 92.08 watts of the 16-inch MacBook Pro M1 Max. Devices that are compatible with PD, PPS, or QC5 protocols can get a higher charging power. Below the USB ports are the 3 AC outlets. The specification is 230 volts, 1650 watts. And there is the LED light. Each module has its own switch button. There is a hidden cover on the back. Inside the cover is an AC input socket, an overload protector, and a DC input socket. The DC socket can achieve a maximum input of 50V, 5A, 400W through a car charger or solar energy. Before use, you can install the EHOM app on your phone. After opening it, you can connect to the power station via Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. You can control the output of each port by their switch sliders. It supports setting the upper limit of charging, lower limit of discharging, and standby time. You can turn on the spur flux in settings. It also supports OTA. The application is easy to use. The spur flux technology allows the power station to output a greater power than the rated power of 1650 watts. It allows the power station to meet the power requirements of most high power appliances, such as kettles and electric frying pans. When the power station supplies power to multiple electrical appliances, the output power can exceed up to 2000 watts and work normally. And when the rated power of the electrical appliances is greater than its rated power, it can automatically reduce the output voltage to reduce the load to prevent it from being overloaded. Compared with other power stations, it supports trickle output mode. When running low power appliances such as CPAP machines, it can be loaded for a long time. Other power stations may go into sleep mode or shutdown after a period of low load. When it is necessary to increase the power operation, it can be waken up immediately. You connect to the coffee machine, an electric frying pan, a CPAP machine, a car refrigerator, 2 laptops, and 3 phones to the power station during testing. At this time, the power is between 1700 to 1800 watts, and it can still work normally. It supports the QuiteQuiet technology. When powering a CPAP machine, the noise meter shows the noise is about 45 decibels at a distance of about 1 meter. There is no obvious noise, which is almost the same as the ambient sound. Its noise control performance is excellent. Next is the full charging test. Use the original power cord to charge it, and the real-time input power can reach more than 1,100 watts. It supports the natural go fast charging technology, and the charging power can be up to 1,200 watts. It can also be charged immediately after fully released, which reduces the restless waiting. Recharge it with the original high-power power cord and record the data with the PA300 power meter. We plot the data into a curve to see how fast it can be charged. It can be charged to 50% in 28 minutes, 80% in 45 minutes, and 100% in 1 hour and 30 minutes. It confirms to what it claims. It can also support an input power of up to 400 watts by solar panel. It can be fully charged in 3.3 hours at the fastest. Even outdoors, users can be provided with a way to charge. Next is the discharging test. Let it continue to output at 1600 watts until the power is exhausted and record the data. The test results are as follows. It can be seen that when the power station continues to output for 40 minutes, the remaining power is 50%. After 20 minutes of output, the remaining power is 30%. And the remaining power is exhausted at 28 minutes. The data is for reference only. In actual use, it generally does not continue to output at 1600 watts for such a long time. These are the tests for the power station. It has 1 kWh of electricity and an output power of 1650 watts. And it is equipped with 5 USB ports and 3 AC outlets. It is not only suitable for outdoor camping but can also be used as energy storage at home. It can output more power than the rated power and can output more than 2000 watts for a short time. The noise while working is pretty low. It supports input power of 1200 watts AC and takes just over 1 hour to be fully charged. It has a balanced performance among similar products and is also quite competitive. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!